welcome to the Marley Bird YouTube channel. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to make some super cute Baby Jane booties by Linda Sear. This is a free pattern available over at redheart.com. I'm gonna show you what you need to get started and then we'll jump right in on the pattern, okay? For this project, you're gonna first need to download the pattern over at redheart.com. The link is provided to you for you down there in the video notes. You'll also need a skein of Red Heart with Love. I'm using the colorway Bubblegum. A pair of size 6 circular needles. Straight needles will work, but I prefer circulars. You'll need 2 size 6 double-pointed needles, some stitch markers, a tapestry needle to weave in your ends, a good pair of scissors, and last but not least, a decorative button, sewing thread, and needle to sew on the button onto your booty itself. You can see right there, I've chosen a really cute butterfly for these pink booties. Grab all of your materials, join me back here, and I'm gonna get you started on these booties. You'll be able to complete your entire project with this video help today. Okay, here you go. You've got all of your materials, now let's go ahead and jump in with the pattern. The pattern states that it wants you to cast on 28 stitches. I'm going to use a long tail cast on today for those 28 stitches, and I'm going to make sure that my tail is extra long. The reason I'm going to do that is because I'm actually going to use my tail to sew up the bottom sole of the booties. And so that way I don't have to add on extra yarn when I wanna sew up this bottom part of the booty. It'll already be there. So I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna place my slip knot right here, and I'm gonna put that directly onto my needle. Now this slip knot in knitting, it does count as a stitch. So I'm gonna count that as one stitch and I'm gonna prepare for my long tail cast on. If you remember before in previous videos, the long tail cast on, you make sure that you have the tail wrapped over your thumb and the working yarn wrapped over your pointer finger. When you carry those both down and hold them with your remaining 3 fingers, you get a slingshot looking effect. So to begin with, I'm making sure I'm holding onto my slip knot onto my needle. I'm taking my needle and I'm gonna go down here to the bottom part of my thumb, go up my thumb, swivel around, tip of my finger, go down my finger, go through the window there, and then off of my thumb. I'm gonna do that one more time because now I've readjusted. I go up my thumb, swivel around, go down my finger, and I have this nice little window I've created, and I'm gonna swing through the window and off of my thumb. When I pull the tails apart, it actually tightens that stitch up right onto my needle. I'll do that a couple more times here for you guys to see. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Go ahead and carry on doing this until you get 28 stitches on your needle. I have 28 stitches on my needle now. I've went and I've counted all those, and you can see I have this really nice long tail. So to make sure that my tail stays out of the way and nice and clean for me, I'm going to wrap it around 2 of my fingers, and then I'm gonna take that off my fingers and pinch it just like that, and wrap my tail this way around the fingers. And on the last wrap around, I put my forefinger in there just so that I get a place to thread the end of the tail through, and when I give it a pull, it will hold that little thing in place so I don't have to worry about it, right? Perfect, I love that, little tips like that. Okay, so now I have the tail out of the way, I'm ready to move on, and I'm beginning row 1. And row 1 is just a knit row, and it's a wrong side row. So I'm gonna show you how to work a couple of stitches in knitting, both in continental and English, and then I'll have you meet me back here and we'll begin row 2, which is where all the action starts. So for a knit stitch, what you need to do is you take your right hand needle, you go into the stitch, take your yarn and you wrap it around, going around the right hand needle, come out the stitch and then off the left hand needle. So I'm in the stitch, around the needle, out of the stitch, and then have the one that I came out of jump off the left hand needle. When I was teaching my kids, I used to say in the front door, around the corner, out the window, jump off the porch. So I'm in the front door, around the corner, out the window, off the porch. I'm gonna show you how to do that holding it in your left hand. As you guys know, that is my preferred method of knitting. And it's the exact same thing. I'm in the front door, around the corner, through the window, off the porch. In the front door, around the corner, through the window, off the porch. So it's the exact same movement, exact same motion. I'm just holding my yarn in the opposite hand, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to finish up this knit row and we will begin row two. Alrighty, we've cast on and we've knitted one row and it's time to jump into row two. For row two, we're gonna begin working our increases. So this is where all of the action begins. So the instructions say that we're going to go ahead and we're gonna knit one stitch. Now I'll come across a stitch that says M1. If this is your first time knitting anything that has a make one or an M1, this might be a little bit confusing to you, or if you've always treated M1s as yarn overs, you don't want to do that. We really want to treat this as an actual make one, and the reason we're going to do that is because we want this to be a somewhat invisible increase. So to do a make one, here's what we need to do. We're going to take our right-hand needle and this strand of yarn right there, so it's the strand that connects that stitch on my left-hand needle and the stitch I just knit on my right-hand needle. It's the strand that connects that. I'm taking my right-hand needle, I'm scooping it up, and I'm gonna take my left-hand needle and swoop and put it right onto my left-hand needle. So now I have that strand sitting right on my left-hand needle. I wanna knit it through the back leg, or the leg that's the hardest to get into. So this really is, it's really hard to get into that back leg right there. So here's my little tip, this is what I do. I take my right-hand needle and I go into the strand as if I'm going to purl, and then I swirl it around. See how I swirled my right-hand needle around that stitch, and now I'm sticking it in the back leg of that stitch. Can you see that? So I'm in the back leg of that stitch and now I knit it just like I normally would. So I yarn over, pull my stitch through, and jump off the porch. So I've increased a stitch there. I've done a make one and it's invisible. If you were to knit that stitch through the front leg or from the leg that's the easiest to get into, you would get a hole and it's just not that pretty. So we've done our make one. So now we need to knit 12. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now we're at the part of the instructions where it says we got to do another make one. So I'm going to take my right hand needle. I'm going to pick up that strand. I'm going to take my left hand needle and I'm going in front of the strand and I'm scooping it up. See how it's sitting right there on my needle. So I'm going to do my little tricky dick thing. So I take my right hand needle. I go in as if I'm going to purl. I swoop it around and I go ahead and I knit through the back leg. Got that? So now I go ahead and I knit one. And the instructions say that we're going to repeat all of that two times. So it's everything that was in the brackets, we're going to repeat another time. So we're going back to, we have to do a knit one and we have an M1 again. So I'm scooping it up, taking my left-hand needle and swooping it and putting it right onto, putting the strand on my left-hand needle. Take my right-hand needle, go in as if to purl and swivel it around. So now I'm in the back leg of that strand. Yarn over, come through and jump off the porch. So I've created my stitch. I knit 12, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I do a make one. This one's a little bit tricky because it's the end here, but the strand is right there. So I pick up the strand, put it on my left-hand needle, take my right-hand needle, go in as if to purl, swivel it around, and knit. And then I knit my last stitch. So I've just completed my full row of increases. What I've done here is I've increased at the beginning, I've increased at the end, and I've increased here in the middle. What's happening is this is the back heel of the booties, and so it's making it so it gives it a nice little curve from the sole. And then this part here, that's the front of the booty, so it's the toe that's gonna come up. The next row, row three, you're just going to knit, and then we're gonna begin row four. I've already done that, so I'm gonna jump over and I'm gonna grab the next yarn. So go ahead and knit your row three, and then we will come back right over here, and we're gonna start row four right now, okay? So I've gone ahead, and I've knit row three, and I'm beginning row four. So row four begins with a star this time. So we're not dealing with a bracket, we're dealing with a star. which means that that's going to be a point at which we begin to repeat the pattern. So it's just one of those things to make note of. I start off with a knit two. So knit one, knit two, and then we have to work an increase. So again, I'm going to take my needle. I'm swooping in. I'm picking up the stitch or the strand. I should call it a strand. I take my left needle and I put the strand on my left-hand needle. I'm using my right needle to swoop-de-doop around, yarn over, and knit. So I've just done my make one. So now I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to knit 12 because that's what it says. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And then the instructions say we're going to do a make one. So I'm going to pick up the strand, put the strand on my left-hand needle, do my whoop-de-doop, and knit that off. So I've done my make one. Now I need to knit two. So knit one, knit two. And I see another asterisk here, another star. That does not mean I need to stop there at this point. I need to continue on still. So it says that I need to make one after the star. So I'm going to do another make one. So I'm picking up my strand, putting it on my left-hand needle, doing my whoop-de-doop, and I'm knitting that stitch. So I did my make one. Now it says the repeat from star to star. So this is where I will stop at the second star. So I go back to the first one, and it says knit two. So I'm going to knit one, knit two. I'm going to do a make one, pick up my strand, put it on my left-hand needle, do my whoop-de-doop, and knit it. Now I go ahead and I knit 12. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I'm going to do a make one. So I'm going to pick up the strand, put it on the left-hand needle, do my whoop-de-doop around so I'm in the back leg of that strand, yarning over and pulling through so I've created my extra stitch, and I finish off with the knit two. So that's the end of row four. I go ahead on row five, you just knit, and then we do another increase row on row six, and I've already done that as well. So I'm gonna move row four away. And what we're looking at right here is we're looking at a row five already completed, getting ready to begin row six. So I'm gonna put this up on the needles. These are all of our increase rows. That's what we're creating right here. So row six begins with a knit three. And one thing you'll notice about row six is it doesn't have any brackets or any stars. It gives you all of the instructions across the whole row right there in that full set of instructions. So we have a knit three, and then we do a make one, just like we've been doing all along. So we pick up the strand, put the strand on our left-hand needle, do my whoop-de-doop. So now I'm in the back leg of that strand, yarn over and pull through. So now I've increased that stitch. Now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to knit 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I have a make one again, so I'm going to pick up my strand, put it on my left-hand needle, and swivel around and do my make one. Did you get that? So then I'm going to knit two, so knit one, knit two, do another make one, pick up my strand, put up my left-hand needle, go in as if to purl, and I swivel around. So I'm in the back leg of that make one, and I go ahead and knit it. Now I knit three, knit one, two, three, do another make one. So I pick up my strand, put it on my needle. I did my make one. I knit two, one, two, do a make one, pick up my strand, put on my left-hand needle, whoop-de-doop around, and I did my make one. And then I knit 12. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I do a make one, so I pick up my loop or my strand, put up my left-hand needle, do my whoop-de-doop, do my stitch increase, and then I finish off with a knit three. That is the end of my increases, and if I set this down, it's really kind of hard to see where any increases or action stitches have happened here, but they're here. So we have increases over here, and increases right here at the center. The next part of the instructions, they want you to just knit for rows 7 through 14. And if you're like me, you'll have a little bit of trouble being able to keep track of which row is which. So this is where your stitch marker is going to come into play. This is what I like to do whenever I have to do a set number of rows. I will put a stitch marker in the first row so that way I have a point of reference to be able to count from. I'm going to show you what I mean. Let's look down here. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to begin knitting row 7 as if I was going to knit the whole row. So what I would do here is I go ahead and I would knit the first stitch. And once I knit that first stitch, I'm going to take my stitch marker right here. And you can see it's just a removable stitch marker, any stitch marker that you can remove. And I'm going to place the stitch marker directly into the stitch that's resting on the needle. When I put it in that stitch that rests on the needle, I have a point of reference now to go back to be able to count my rows. So now that that stitch is on there, I can carry on and knit the rest of the row and then continue on through row 14. I want you to go ahead and continue on knitting rows 7 through 14. Join me back here and we will begin on row 15. You've completed through row 14 and you're ready to get started with the decreases so that we can jump into the strap. Let me show you how to do that. You can see my mark stitch here. That was my row 7, and so it's easy for me to count to know I'm on row 15. If that was row 7, and I know garter stitch rows count as 2 rows, so for that garter stitch row, that's row 7 and 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So can you see how the stitch marker really helps you be able to go back and count? So that way you know that both of your booties are going to be the same size. To begin, this row has me start by knitting 13 stitches. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to do that first. So there is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I have 13 stitches and now it's time for me to do a decrease and I'm going to do an SSK. The reason Linda Sear has us do an SSK is because she wants us to do a full fashion decreasing, meaning these first set of decreases are going to lean to the left and then the second set of decreases are going to lean to the right. To do that, we begin with an SSK. To do an SSK, you take your right hand needle and you go into the stitch on your left hand needle as if to knit and slip it off. You do that for 2 stitches, so slip as if to knit, slip as if to knit. Now you take your left hand needle and you put it into the front leg of those 2 slipped stitches. So it looks as if I'm knitting through the back leg. I go ahead, I yarn over my right hand needle and pull that stitch through both stitches and then I let those stitches go off my left hand needle. So what was 2 stitches has now become 1 and these stitches lean to the left. I'm going to do that 3 more times. So I slip as if to knit, slip as if to knit, left hand needle goes into the stitches as into the front leg of the stitches, yarn over, pull through, and I knit it off. Do that 2 more times. So I slip as if to knit, left hand needle goes into the front leg of those 2 stitches, yarn over my right hand needle, and pull off. So I've just knitted it. 1 more time. I slip as if to knit. These are on their backwards, slip as if to knit, slip as if to knit. I put them on my left hand needle, yarn over and pull through. Okay, so I have 4 stitches there in what used to be 8 stitches and they all lean to the left. I go ahead and I knit 1 and now I have to do a knit 2 together. And what's gonna happen here is when I knit 2 stitches together, it's literally I'm just knitting 2 stitches together at the same time. So I'm taking my needle, I'm going into this stitch over here to the left of the stitch that's closest to the tip of the needle. I'm going into that one and then I go into the stitch tip closest to the tip of the needle and I just knit them together. These ones are going to lean to the right. And what happens after I do that, I'm going to have this nice full fashion decrease at the toe of my booty. So here I'm going to do the last one and I'm going to show you what I mean. So right here, I have 4 stitches that lean to the left, I have 1 stitch at the center, and I have 4 stitches that lean to the right. Then I go ahead and I finish off my row by knitting 13. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. After you knit the 13 and you finish up the row, you're going to go ahead and you're going to knit the next row. So row 16 is just knit. And then row 17 is where we have to bind off those center stitches to prepare for the top of the bootie. So I've already done that. I'm going to jump over and do that. So after you have finished row 15, go ahead and knit row 16, and then you're ready to begin right where I am right now, which is row 17. So for row 17, we're going to begin doing bind offs. And this can seem a little bit tricky if this is the first time you've ever done this. So I'm going to show you how to do this and how to keep track of your stitches. To start off row 17, we need to go ahead and knit the 8 stitches as it's indicated. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now it says bind off 19. Now I don't want to interrupt these 8 stitches I've just knit, so I'm going to go ahead and begin my bind off by knitting 2 more stitches. So I'm going to knit 1, knit 2, and have that second stitch, or the first stitch I did, jump over the second stitch. So that's going to begin my bind off. So that's 1. And I need to do that until I get a total of 19. So there's 2, knit 1, have the back one jump over. There's 3. I'm going to do this all the way down until I get 19. So I've just got 18, and here's my 19th one. And when I do that, I'm left with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 stitches. But the instructions say to knit 8. Ah, you've got to remember, this stitch right there, the last one left over from my bind off, counts as a stitch. So that's my 8. So there's 1, and then I'm going to go 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So what I'm left with here is I have my beginning 8, my bound off 19, and my ending 8. Go ahead and finish up your row 17, and then we're going to move on to the strap. I'm going to show you how to do the strap for the right bootie and the left bootie. All right, here we go. All right, we're almost done with the booties, and it's time to do the strap for the right bootie. So that's what we're going to jump in and start with right now. If we look down here, you can see that I have all of my stitches completed as far as I have my bound off stitches here and my right stitches, or my right 8 stitches and my left 8 stitches. What I'm going to do is it says in the instructions to slip each set of 8 stitches onto double pointed needles. So that's where my double pointed needles come into play. So I'm going to grab my needles and I'm going to start over here, and I'm going to slip these stitches as if to purl. The reason I'm doing that is because I don't want to change the orientation of these stitches. I want them to still be the way they are on the needle. I don't want them twisted. So I'm slipping each one as if to purl, and I'm going to do each one separately. So that's one set. I'm going to come over here and I'm going to grab my second double pointed needle, and I'm going to do this set. So I'm going to slip it again as if to purl. So I'm going into each one as if to purl, and I'm slipping them off the circular directly onto the double points. What this is going to do is it's going to make us it's going to make it easier to orient the stitches the way we want them to be to make the bootie form. If you can see here, I have just closed, it's like I've closed it up and I've matched 8 stitches to 8 stitches, right? It's pretty cool. Or you can think of it as I've matched the heel on this side to the heel on this side. What it says is it says rotate the needle so that the edge, your heel edges of the booty meet with the right side facing. And how do you know it's the right side, you guys? You want to make sure the pearls are facing you. So if I am sitting here like this, I am looking at the wrong side because my pearls, they're not there. I'm looking at knits. My pearls are back there. So this is where having the double points really comes in handy because I can just rotate it around just like that. And I'm looking at my right side. See? I'm looking at my right side because I'm looking at pearls. My heel edge is butted up to each other and everything's good there. It says I need to go ahead and cut my yarn at this point. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to cut my yarn. I'm going to leave at least a 6 to 8 inch tail for this one because I want to be able to use this tail to weave in or to sew up my heel right there. So that's what I'm going to use that for. So I'm going to let that be. And it says that it wants me to go ahead and join the yarn at the edge of the foot so that way I can work around. So I'm going to turn this like this. I'm going to join the yarn and begin working this direction and then back onto that foot. Now, here's what I did that made it just seem a little bit easier for me to understand this. Once I got my orientation right and I was like, okay, this is where I am. I'm going to join my yarn here. I'm going to knit across these stitches. And then I have to knit this stitch together with that stitch, doing a knit two together. Well, it's kind of hard to do that when they're separated by two double points. So what you can do at this point is now that I have these oriented the way I want them, I can take these stitches and go ahead and slip them all onto one double pointed needle. Now, you have to do this after they're already oriented the way you want them to be so that you make sure everything's in the right place. Now I have all the stitches on there where I need them to be, all 8 stitches, so 16 I should say, because I have 8 here and 8 here. And the instructions say I'm going to knit 7 and knit 2 together and then knit 7. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my circular needle because I can use that now. And I'm going to grab my extra yarn and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to join my yarn and begin knitting. So to join the yarn, it's really super simple. You go ahead, you go in like you're going to knit. And you just yarn over with your brand new yarn, making sure you have the right end of the yarn. Yarn over and pull through and you knit it off. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now it says to knit 2 together, and it says on the instructions that it'll be knit one stitch from each needle. But now that we've combined them on one needle, I don't have to worry about that. See how much easier it is? So I just come in and I knit 2 together. What that's going to do, it's going to join it, okay? Just ignore how that kind of comes loose a little bit, and then you finish off with the knit 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Finished my row. I can put my double point needle out of the way because I don't need it anymore. And I'm ready to go. You see that? See how it's nice and joined? Everything's good. I'm ready to move on to the second row, but I'm not done with the first row in the sense that it says to cast on 13 stitches. Now, when you cast on 13 stitches, you can go ahead and you could do a backwards E cast on. What you would do is you grab your yarn, take your thumb, and you just go like this. And then just kind of like you were doing a long tail, you go up and scoop it on. You could do that 13 times, all right? You could absolutely do that. Or you could do a cable cast on, which is what I prefer. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. I'm gonna take those backwards E cast ons off, and I'm gonna show you how to do the cable cast on. Now to do the cable cast on, I need to go ahead and turn my work. And then using the other end of my circular needle, this is what I'm going to do, okay? We are going to work between the stitches to cast on stitches. We're not going to actually work into a knit stitch for this part, okay? So I'm going to go between these two stitches, going to yarn over and come through just as if I was knitting, okay? Now I'm right here and I'm going to extend that loop that I pulled through and I'm going to come over here and take my left needle and swoop around and put it directly onto my left-hand needle. You see that? So I take my right hand needle again, and now I'm going to go between these two stitches. So I'm going in between them, yarn over my needle, pull up a loop. I'm going to extend that loop up come over here, take my left needle, and swoop it right back on. So I'm putting it onto my left-hand needle. So that's three stitches, right? Or that's two stitches. So I'm going to yarn over, pull through, come up, extend, and swoop. See how that goes? It's pretty cool, right? So I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to do that until I get 13. Extend, come around, and swoop. Come in, extend, come around, and swoop. Swoop it on. How do you like all my little terms, my Jimmy What's-its? I don't know what to call them sometimes, and I have to sit here and try and think of a way to say it. And honestly, this is what I would say to classes I was teaching. So this works out that I am able to just kind of talk to you guys a little bit as I'm doing this stuff. Then I got to go back and count and swoop, because as I talk, I forget what my stitch count is. And it's not just as easy as going back and counting 13, because you don't want to mistakenly count one too many or one too short, because then you won't have straps that match on both booty, right? So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to put that one on there. And I know that I began with 16 over here, but I decreased one. Remember, I did a knit two together. So now I only have 15. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So anything past that mark. So now I have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13, 14. So I'm going to take one off. And I have 13 stitches. Okay? See how nice those stitches are resting on my needle? Like, it's so much easier to work into those than a backwards E. So now I've cast on my 13 stitches and I'm ready to move on to row two, which is just knit. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to jump in and do that. And you're going to knit these stitches just like you would anything else. So this time, instead of going between those stitches, we're going to actually work into the stitches we've created. So I'm going into the stitch, yarning over, pulling up a loop, and jumping off. So I'm going to go ahead and do that all the way down this row. I just finished my knit row and I'm beginning to do row three, which is my buttonhole row. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to knit 25 stitches. Now, here's a little tip. You want to make sure that your buttonhole you're going to create works with the button you've chosen. So if you have not chosen a button at this point, I highly suggest you go and pick out a button so that you can make your buttonhole perfectly fit the button you're going to use. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going down to knit my 25, and then I'm going to do my buttonhole, which is so easy to create, you guys. I mean, you're going to be like, oh my gosh, that's all that you have to do? Yes, it's all you have to do. I'm almost done with my 25 stitches here, and I'm going to place my buttonhole right here. So to create in the buttonhole, all I'm going to do is I'm going to yarn over my needle. So I take my yarn, I go from back to front, over top of my right-hand needle, and back to the back. That's a yarn over, okay? I'm going to hold it with my finger, and now I've got to do an SSK. So we've been doing those already, right? So we go into the stitch as if to knit and slip it off, go into the stitch as if to knit and slip it off, and then go in with your left-hand needle into the front leg of both of those stitches, knit them together, all right? So what we've done here is with our yarn over, we've created an increase, but with our slip, slip, knit, we've created a decrease. So we still have our correct number of stitches that we want. We finish off with a knit one, and that's the end of that row. Now, the next row, it tells us to knit and then bind off. And it has that all written within the same row. So row 17 is a knit row and a bind off row at the same time. If you choose to knit the whole row and then bind off the next row, which would technically be row 18, you could do that. It just will make your strap look a little bit different. What I like to do is go ahead and do as it's as instructed, which is we're going to knit and bind off at the same time. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to knit two stitches. I'm going to take my left-hand needle and have the back stitch leapfrog up and over the front stitch. And I do that all the way down the row. Even my yarn over, I treat my yarn over the same way. I just knit into it, up and over. Knit in, up and over. Okay? What I've done here is I've created a nice little hole for my buttonhole, and I'm binding off for my strap all the way down. All right? I'm going to set this aside so that I can show you what this is going to look like when it's all complete. So when your bind off is complete for your right booty, you can see right here that you get a nice hole for your buttonhole, and you want to make sure again that that will fit your button. And then you have all of your bound off stitches right here. Okay, you can absolutely knit one more row and then bind off the next row. It's totally your prerogative. Once that is complete, the only thing left to do is to sew up the heel and the sole of the booty, and you would be complete other than putting the button on and then just buttoning it closed. Before I show you how to do that portion, I want to show you how to make the left booty. You've almost completed the full right booty, and I'm going to show you now how to do the left booty strap because it is a little bit different from the right in that we're going to reverse the order and the way we did everything. Join me down here. I'm going to show you what I mean. Down here, I've gone ahead and I've put our 8 stitches on 2 double pointed needles, just like we did when we did the right booty strap. In the instructions, it tells us that it wants us to go ahead and meet up the wrong sides facing us. So it would be the wrong sides facing us and have the heel edge beat up. Then it says to go ahead and continue on just like you did in the right side pattern. What I don't like about doing it this way is that it disturbs our garter stitch pattern. Unless we chose to go ahead and do purl stitches along everything instead of knits, we're gonna disrupt our pattern that we have going on here. So I'm gonna show you the way I thought it was really good to change this pattern up a little bit and made it a little bit easier to do the left strap. So I have the stitches now laying exactly like they were for the right strap. So I have the right side facing me. This is as if I was going to join the yarn right here at the foot edge, knit my 7, knit my 2 together, and then knit my 7. On the right side, it wanted me to then continue on and cast on 13 stitches. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cast on 13 stitches to begin with, and then knit my 7, knit 2 together, knit my 7. So I'm doing it opposite. If you remember when we did the right one, we went ahead and we joined these stitches all onto one double pointed needle because it's easier when I do the knit 2 together to join the heel section. So I'm gonna put them all on one needle, and I'm ready to go with that. Now I've got to prepare my 13 stitches that I want cast on over here. So I'm going to cast those on my needle first before I start working into these stitches. So I'm going to set this down and I'm going to grab my yarn. Now, just as I did the right side, I am going to start off by casting on with a cable cast on. The difference here is that I have to begin my cable cast on by working into my slip stitch first, and then I will work between my stitches for all the stitches beyond that. So to start off here, I have a slip knot on my needle. Let me slip that out of the way so you can see a little bit better. I have my slip knot on my needle. I'm gonna go ahead, go into the stitch just like I was going to knit it. And I am going to knit it. I'm gonna yarn over my needle, pop that out. And instead of having this stitch jump off my left-hand needle, I'm gonna extend the loop I just created, come up here, just like we did the cable cast on before. I pull this down, take my left needle and swoop it underneath that to put that loop on my left-hand needle. Now I have 2 stitches, so I can start going between my stitches. So I have 2 stitches, I need 11 more. So I'm gonna go between the 2 stitches. You can see I'm between them. I'm going to work a knit stitch. So I'm gonna yarn over my needle, pull it through between the stitches, extend that loop, pull it up, take my left-hand needle, come in and swoop it on. So now I have 3 stitches. Go between, yarn over my needle, come out, extend, come in, and swoop. Continue that until you have 13 stitches. You can watch me go through this whole process right here. I'm trying to go nice and slow for you. One thing that's nice about this, working the left hand or the left side strap versus the right, is that I know I get 13 stitches at the end of this just by counting all of my cast on stitches. Whereas before, if I lost count, I had to count my beginner stitches too, just because I have a hard time distinguishing between the cast on stitches and the very last stitch of my knitted stitches sometimes. So I just like to be sure. I'm almost done here. I'm going to go between my stitches, yarning over my needle, pop it on through, extend, left needle comes in and swoops it on. Let's see where we are so far. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I have 3 more. So I have 1, 2, 3. Now, again, I chose this cast on so that it would look just like the cast on I used for the right strap. If you wanted to use a long tail cast on or a knitted cast on or some other cast on method, you absolutely could, but I wanted this to match up as well as best I could to the right strap. So now I have my cast on stitches and I'm ready to go. So just like before, when we were working on the right strap, what we did is we worked 7 stitches, knit 2 together, 7 stitches, and then we cast on 13. Well, we've already cast on our 13, so now we're just going to jump right in and knit our 7. So I'm going to go over here and I'm going to begin knitting our 7. You can see I'm using my circular needle again. I'm just using my double points for that initial separation of the stitches so that I can get everything oriented correctly. And then I put everything on one needle and I go back to my circular needle. I find it easier to do it that way. That's why I decided to do that. And I'm coming up to my 7th stitch right here. And I'm going to do a knit 2 together. Now remember, knit 2 together, I come into the stitch that's left side of the stitch closest to the tip, go through both stitches. You can see I'm through both stitches, yarn over, and come through both of them. So I have just done a decrease. And then I carry on with my knit 7. Pay no attention to the stitch right here that gets a little bit loose. It's perfectly normal. When you go to weave in that end, it will tighten it up and it'll be just fine. So I'm going to go to the end. And when I get to the end here, I'm at the end of my row. So I don't have to cast on any more stitches. So I carry on with row 2, just like I did my right side, which was just a knit row. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and set my double pointed needle out of the way and grab the other end of my circular. And I'm going to knit this row. No extra action or anything else happens on this row, just a bunch of knits. And when I get down to my cast on stitches, I'm going to treat them just as if they were just normal old stitches like I'm doing right here. They're not going to be anything, nothing special is going to be done to them. They're just going to be knitted in. And it's just like I just did an extension of the booty, which I did. I just created a strap. So I'm coming down here to the very last of my body stitches, and I'm going into the strap stitches that I cast on. So I'm just working into each one individually, no special treatment, and I get a very nice cast on. It's much easier to work with than the backwards E cast on. As I said, you could have done a long tail cast on, it would have been perfectly fine. But I chose to do the cable cast on, one, because I think it's really pretty, and two, it matches up the other side or the right strap that I did earlier. So I'm at the end here. Now, just like we reversed the order of the cast on stitches, we need to reverse the order of our buttonhole. The reason is when we did our buttonhole before, we did it at the end. So we knitted 25 and then we did a yarn over and then an SSK. This time we're going to begin with a knit 1, knit 2 together, yarn over, because we want our buttonhole over here at the end of our strap. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to knit 1 and I'm going to do a knit 2 together. The reason I'm doing a knit 2 together is because I want my decrease to lean in the direction, in this direction, just like the other one leaned to the left. Now I'm going to do a yarn over. So a yarn over, I'm in the back of my work. I come up between my needles to the front of my work, go up back over the right hand needle, and I'm back to the back of my work ready to knit the next stitch. I'm going to finish off by knitting to the end of the row. Go ahead and switch hands as I'm knitting along. I've been trying to show you how to knit continental and English throughout this entire video so that way you guys can get used to looking at both methods and decide which one is best for you, which one is easier for you to understand and accomplish a knit project yourself. When I get to the end of this row, I am back to row 17. I'm sorry, not 17. I am back to row 4 of the strap, which is a knit row and a bind off row. Now, the way Linda Sear wrote the instructions, just as I told you, we were working the right hand strap, she wrote it so that it says knit and then there's a period, then it says bind off. You have to make a decision whether you want to knit the row and then bind off, or if you do a knitted bind off. That's what I'm going to do because that's what I did on the first booty. I keep wanting to call them mittens. That's what I did on the first booty. I knitted and bound off at the same time. So here I am. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to knit 2 stitches just like I would any normal bind off. And I take my left hand needle, go into the back stitch on my right hand needle, have it jump up and over that first stitch. And I continue on doing that down the entire row. Once you finish off the bind off of the booty, come back here. I'm going to show you how to seam up the heel and the bottom of the booty. Now you've created two super cute booties. They may not look like much yet because you still have to weave in your ends and seam up your seams, but don't worry, I'm going to show you how to do that. If you look down here, you can see the two booties I've created in today's video. Here's my right one and here's my left one. There are quite a few tails to still weave in, but it's not that big of a deal. If you use your tapestry needle, again, I love to use my steel tapestry needle, and you follow along the path of the knit stitch, you can weave in your ends with no problem. Remember, we created a long tail when we began, so that way we could use this tail to seam up the bottom portion of our seam, of our booty. We also left a longer tail when we cut the yarn and began for the strap so that we could use this to seam up our heel. And that's what we're going to do right now. I'm going to toss that one out of the way and pull this one over because I've already tucked in the ends for this one with the exception of the two I want to show you. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm grabbing my tapestry needle and I'm turning my work upside down. And I'm going to take my tail and I'm going to thread it onto my tapestry needle. Here's a little tip. If you take the tail and you pinch it around the eye of the needle, just real tight like that, and then take the eye of the needle and wiggle it on there, you can thread that through your needle really quickly. Now, what's great with the garter stitch that we've done is we have the rows like side by side, and we have these nice garter stitch bumps. So what we're gonna do is we're going to take a bump at a time. So I'm gonna go into that bump, come up and pull, come into this purl bump right there, come up and pull it, and then go to the one corresponding it on the other side. As I do this down the whole row, it's going to pull together this seam really nice and tight, and it's going to be beautiful. So I'm going into each purl bump on each row, and I'm just giving it a little bit of a pull. You can tell I'm not pulling it super tight yet. And the reason is I know I can pull it tight now. Pull it snug, give it a little snip. Look at that. Look how cute that is. It's like perfect. I can continue on. Let's see, I finished off there. I'm going to go on to that one. And I just go all the way down until I have each row butted up to the row on the other side. Once I get down there, I weave in any extra length that I have on this particular tail. And I'm going to then jump in and begin using my extra tail that I have from my cast on to seam up the bottom sole. So you can see here, I'm done with the heel and you can't even see, it looks seamless. Look how pretty that is. I'm just going to let that hang out. Okay, I will weave that in later and I'm going to show you how to use this. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to pull this up apart. Remember, I just kind of did a really quick little butterfly tie just to hold it in place. And I have I created a knot there on accident. I'm going to just cut that off so I don't have to deal with it and get rid of it. Okay. So here I am, I'm at my tail, ready for the bottom of my booty. I'm going to thread my needle again. I'm going to pinch that around, wiggle that right on, and get this ready to go. Can you see how this works? Just going one for one, all the way across. So as it gets pulled closed, it butts up together and they look seamless. Isn't that great? I'm going to show you on one that's already finished. I'm going to pull this one over. So I've done that all the way down this entire row here. And you can see that this end butts up right up to that end and you have a really great, super cute booty. Now let's talk about the button. One of the things about the buttons that really scares me is that it is a choking hazard, and we're going to give these to a baby. So that's one of the first things you want to be conscientious of. Make sure if you're giving this to a new mother to be, you warn them that these little buttons, they're choking hazards. So don't leave them on there as like permanent things. When I was a new mom, one thing that I really despised doing was putting buttons through buttonholes. Ironically enough, I just showed you how to do buttonholes. So what I did when I made these cute little booties that I'm going to give away to my kid's godmother is I added sew-on snaps. because I find they're so much easier to snap on a booty than trying to finagle a button through a buttonhole down around the ankle of a little baby. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to add these little sew-on snaps. And these are the ones I had on hand. I know that they sell diaper, like people, a lot of people make their own disposable or reusable diapers now, and they use really cool snaps. So they have specific like diaper snaps that you could probably use too for the booties, but I find them so much easier. And then what I did was, is I took a really cute decorative button and I added it to the top there. So it was a way for me to get around having to finagle this button through a buttonhole. And I know that I can just snap these on no problem to a baby's booty. The other thing is, if you're going to do this, you don't have any need for a buttonhole. So on the buttonhole row of the strap, you're just going to knit. You won't create a buttonhole at all. You'll just knit across and it'll be, you know, honky dory. Once you finish these up, you are ready to give them away to your favorite person or favorite baby shower. Now you know how to make the Baby Jane booties. I hope you enjoyed this video and you have a new project to make for the next baby shower you go to. Make sure you hit subscribe, or as my kids say, smash that like button. I'll be talking to you again soon. I'm Marley Bird for RedHeart.com.